This match is one fall with a 20-minute time limit. First, from Puerto Rico, weighing 239 pounds, Jose Luis Rivera. His opponent, from Manchester, England, weighing in at 241 pounds, Les Thornton.
Certainly looking good, Les Thornton. Gorilla Monsoon, along with Gene Okerlund, almost at ringside.
Almost, but not quite. Side of the battle, away we go.
Should be an interesting matchup here. Les Thornton, the current World Wrestling Federation Junior Heavyweight Champion. Of course, Jose Luis Rivera looking to make a name for himself here in the World Wrestling Federation. Nice counter head scissors. Certainly has come a long way in the last couple of years.
You know, Les Thornton hails from the coal mining district of Northern England in the Manchester area. It is a hotbed for both amateur and professional wrestling in that country, Gorilla.
Certainly have been a number of greats come out of there, as well as all of England and some of Scotland and Wales. Not the least of which is Rowdy Roddy Piper.
Rowdy Roddy would have to be considered another hot ticket of the World Wrestling Federation these days. The tag team known as the British Bulldogs.
British Bulldogs certainly compiling a most interesting record here in the World Wrestling Federation, as they currently go undefeated in all competitions so far in their quest for the title. Nice shoulder block by Les.
Well, I think Rivera had the right idea, just did not get executed properly.
He certainly applies one of the most brutal forearms in all of professional wrestling.
Wow.
Good shot of it right there. Excellently executed.
How about that knee drop?
Down to the cover.
That's
one.
That's not going to happen.
No way. Reverse chin lock. Nice hold to slow this man down with. And take a little bit of control. And, he hit him right in the nose, Gene.
He did indeed. Referee is going to have to periodically check for the possibility of a choke. All you have to do is just move that forearm up underneath the chin, and it automatically becomes a chokehold.
Ever so slightly. The move is almost non-existent as far as what you're able to see, but the guy that's getting it applied on him certainly knows it when it slips into that chokehold. Rivera trying to counter. He's got a nice setup there for an underarm hook. See if he takes advantage of it. Now he's turning it into a standing wrist lock now.
He's going to try to power out. I don't know if he can do that against Thornton.
Thornton is extremely powerful in the upper body.
Look at the leverage as both men spread those legs.
Went down kind of easy. Might have been a bit of hair in there. Of course, once you start losing the leverage, you immediately, a guy like Thornton will immediately go to the locks. Jose Luis still trying to leverage his way out of there. That was obvious right there, right into the head scissors. A handful of hair to help him.
Another great crowd out here this week at the Boston Garden for this World Wrestling Federation event.
As always, the hottest ticket in town, World Wrestling Federation action. Coming your way.
Rivera has got to see that big break come for him shortly.
Boy, I certainly hope so. Turned that one over nicely into a side head scissor, but look how quickly.
Oh, we're seeing a little Greco-Roman action
here. Man of a thousand holes came right out the back door and ends up with this nice chicken wing. Hammerlocked it now.
Oh, look at him really turn it on. He is applying pressure.
It's too bad you can't feel it, Gene. You can only see it. But Rivera certainly feeling it, no question about that.
I felt that. Not like Jose Luis Rivera, however. He's got to get back up on his feet, Gorilla Monsoon, in my estimation.
Well, in order to alleviate the pressure that's being applied now, he's got to... Oh, look at this. Now he threw on a reverse half Nelson. This is a pinning combination right here. If he can get that left shoulder, right shoulder down. He's got one of them down. He's got the other one down. It's a one count, two. No, manages to pick up the left shoulder.
So subtle with that shoulder roll, too.
Thornton definitely in control here. Keeping a nice bridge there by Rivera.
Beautiful bridge on the part of Rivera.
See if he can come up with it. Takes a lot of power. Look at that. Rivera right up, powered right out of there. He's been spending some time in the gym of late.
Wow, what a move on the part of Thornton.
See how he used that leg for extra leverage, Gene. Just now, there's all I'm talking about, that sit out and turn in.
Boy, talk about turnaround being fair play. It's now Rivera in the driver's seat with a hammerlock.
And could just as easily reach around in front and take that reverse half Nelson for himself. Rather, whether that's in his repertoire or not, I don't know, Gene. Certainly should be. Because you're not going to beat Les Thornton with a hammerlock. Or anyone else for that matter.
Thornton going up over the top.
Nice arm drag from that under position. Side headlock. How quick. Thornton is thinking two or three moves ahead of Rivera, Gene, and it's obvious.
I find this, like many sports, becoming more and more a thinking man's game. I think you'd have to agree with me on that point.
No question. No question. If you don't step into that ring with some kind of a game plan, know exactly what you want to do and when you want to do it and how you want to do it, there's no way you're going to be victorious.
It's the old set your objectives, plan the strategy, and then execute. Professional wrestling at its very best as part of the World Wrestling Federation.
You know, Gene, when you take a guy with the experience of a Les Thornton, place him into a match with a Jose Luis Rivera, who has come a long way in the last couple of years here in the World Wrestling Federation. He can't compete on an experienced basis with Les Thornton. He may be able to get lucky in a match of this nature and catch the man of a thousand holes unaware of something that he's going to do. But on the long run, I don't see how Rivera can give away that kind of experience and expect to come out on top. Look at that. Unbelievable counters.
Well, I thought there for a moment Thornton setting Rivera up for a possible atomic drop. Rivera missed on that one, held out of the head and just brought Thornton right on over. Thornton comes up, however, with the head scissors.
As he was going over, he was already contemplating the counter, Gene. It was already there.
Absolutely. That is why, in fact, he is the light heavyweight champion here in the World Wrestling Federation. Native of Manchester, England, Les Thornton.
Just controlling him, making him pay the price right now. You want to be a professional wrestler, you step in with a man of this caliber. The ability that he has, the conditioning that he has. I've seen him in so many 1 hour, 45 minute matches, 2 hour matches. He can go the whole route, Gene. Superb condition. He's not going to run out of gas out there for sure.
Well, wait a minute. As we see Jose Luis Rivera, not somewhat of an offensive, that was hair.
Obviously.
We all saw it. The referee is calling for the break. Wait a minute. Thornton talked himself out of that one. Oh, come on, ref.
Referees take a peek at the rule book once in a while, Gene. It helps a great deal. Rivera using that forward roll again very nicely to his advantage. But notice how quickly Thornton's up. Doesn't want to stay down there. Nice reverse hip lock.
Whoa!
Takes a champ over and another side headlock. Got to go to another hole, Gene. He's not going to get very far.
Wait a minute. There was hair and good grief, ref. If you didn't see that, you'd better see somebody in a cheater's department.
The optician.
The oculist.
Thornton still giving a wrestling lesson to Jose Luis Rivera.
A couple of optometrists and one optimist.
And one optimist. Very good. I love it. I get the feeling down deep in the pit of my stomach, Gene, that Thornton is literally playing with Jose Luis.
I would have to concur with your line of thinking.
You know, that's a bad thing to do, because some nights you're going to go out there with someone who you could beat 99 out of 100 times and maybe think you're going to get a little bit of a workout and go 10 or 15 minutes and a guy's going to surprise you, take a fall on you, and it goes down to record books.
Oh, nifty, nifty move on a part of Rivera. There's hair again by Thornton. And good Lord, ref, give me a break.
They don't pay by the hour in professional wrestling. Go out there and win the match as quick as you can in the best fashion you can. That was my philosophy anyway, Gene.
Well, it worked good for you for a number of years here in the World Wrestling Federation.
I had one match here in the Boston Garden that set a record, 7 seconds. Hardly enough time to get your ring jacket off, but it's still down in the record books.
You won, I hope.
No, definitely not.
Wait a minute. Well, I believe Rivera tried to inform the referee that Thornton is utilizing the tights to secure that pin.
Tough to tell from that position. He's got the grapevine on the shoulder and arm, and the legs hooked as well.
How can the referee, after asking for a break, not get these men up on their feet and clearly break it?
Well, because he obviously doesn't have control of this match, Gene. There goes Rivera. Hard look out. Nobody there. But still, look, he wanted to go back to that side head scissors again. I can't believe that.
Whoa!
He just hesitated, and Thornton was just too quick for him and too smart.
All right, those bootlaces across the side of the face, perhaps into the eyes. They'll slow you down.
There goes Rivera right outside through that second rope down onto the concrete. Forearm shot is what did it.
Boy, he flew through those ropes, too. I don't mind telling you. He took a tremendous tumble at the hands of this man, Les Thornton.
Trying to get some circulation back into that leg. He came down hard on it.
Whoa!
Another forearm shot. Thornton, a master at that. He's got it down to a science. Knows how to place it just where it'll do the most good.
I believe he has to bring it up high enough, too, that you can just put a little of that elbow in that blow also.
That elbow definitely hits you right on the mandible. Thornton just about breaking the sweat at this point in time. Rivera in a very dangerous situation here. He doesn't start mounting some offense very shortly. This one will be terminated in a hurry.
It'll be all over. Oh, wait a minute. Maybe
some set clip. Oh,
hold on. Rope. He's got the rope.
He's hanging on to that second rope. Well, referee finally won. Two count now. Thought Thornton was going to say something to the referee. Look out.
Solo. Beautifully done.
One. No way. Kicked right out. Takes a starch out of you.
Oh, what an uppercut with a forearm. Rocket Luis. Jose Luis Rivera to the canvas in a big hurry. He went down like a ton of bricks.
Wow, just like a rag doll. Look out.
Whoa.
Couldn't hold him. Hooked the leg. Down for the count. Referee, what was he waiting for? Referee went down, but he didn't count, Gene. He lost at least a 1.5 count.
I think Rivera could have had a pin there justifiably.
Reversal.
So.
Look out.
High cross body.
He scooped him right over. Caught him with momentum. Hey. Full of tights. Oh. Rivera went to the well one too many times. And the man with the gray matter put him away.
Here is your winner, Les Thornton.
All right, Gorilla Monsoon, I think it would be very interesting, viewer, if we could go back in time and take a look at just exactly how it all happened, where Les Thornton managed to manipulate and maneuver Jose Luis Rivera. Looks like Rivera has got something going here, but
all
it was
leverage,
not to be.
All leverage and knowledge put to use. Look, a handful
and
of tights. Really didn't need it. He had everything going for him just to add a little insult to injury.
All right, that man right there. Les Thornton this week for the Boston Garden. Get in the Duke here on the World Wrestling Federation.
This match is one fall with a 20-minute time limit. First, from Korea, weighing 271 pounds, Tiger Chung Lee. And soon to be approaching the ring, from Detroit, Michigan, weighing 288 pounds, George the Animal Steel.
action as George the Animal Steele hits the ring here at the Boston Garden this week. Tiger Chung Lee got his hat in a New York second. He was out of there.
Boy, he certainly made a hasty retreat, and I don't blame him because the Animal is the most unpredictable human being in all of professional sports.
Whoa, hold on.
Going after him, that kendo stick. This is going to be a classic, Gene.
I wouldn't expect anything else from George the Animal Steele and veteran Tiger Chung Lee.
Well, the Animal have come a long way here in the last couple of months in the World Wrestling Federation, now under the tutelage of Captain Louis Albano.
And speaking of the good captain, he is a little conspicuous by his absence this week for this match. I certainly thought he would have been here.
Well, he is extremely conspicuous.
Maybe he is here.
He's
somewhere
happy.
Disguised as an old lady.
Could be.
Filming this match in its entirety.
Very possible. Albano's been known to do that. Actually go up and buy a ticket at the window. Come and sit in the third tier of the balcony here in the Boston Garden. Uh-oh! The Steel attacking.
Tiger Chung Lee very fortunate. He didn't get that kendo stick stuck someplace.
Stuffed is the word, I think. Gorilla Monsoon here at ringside with Mean Gene Okerlund in the Boston Garden. Another capacity crowd on hand is, there goes the Animal into that dance of his.
Oh my! Tiger Chung Lee can't make heads or tails out of George Steele. I don't know what to do.
At times I can't either, Gene.
Maybe it was the prudent move, just get out of the way.
Probably the best counter right there, bail out. I think the Animal learned some of that dance of his from JYD, the Junkyard Dog. Tiger Chung Lee now making his way back in, very reluctantly, I might add. But here's a dangerous individual, 285 pounds plus, master of so many martial arts.
And he is one individual who is not above bending or breaking a rule.
Well, at one time, he and Mr. Fuji were very, very good tag team combination.
I recall a falling out that they had when they parted ways in Philadelphia last year.
Wow, was that ever an upset? Holy mackerel. Fuji taught him who the master was, Gene.
Did he ever?
The Animal taking a chunk out of the forearm of Tiger Chung Lee.
Don't you get the impression sometimes that that George still has not got it all together?
Oh, yeah. Still doesn't have both oars in the water, Jim. No way.
Oh, he's planting a can. Oh, my word. Oh, my.
That can be construed at any time as a double disqualification, single disqualification right there.
Well, Tiger Chung Lee had tried for a crescent kick. That didn't work.
Uh-oh.
Outside of the ring. Here we go. Around our ring post, Tiger Chung Lee pops up into the ring, and George a little bewildered by it all. He can't believe that a man would try to run with him.
Look at him. Look around. He's looking for something. You got to watch it. Those steps are pulled out there. He could step right between them and go right out of sight. Both men now back inside. Look at George.
He has got Tiger Chung Lee running.
Got him all psyched out, Gene.
Does he ever?
Tiger, in his haste to get out of the ring, took a pretty good fall there. He might have twisted an ankle or something. Ring apron approximately 4 feet, 4.5, maybe even 5 feet high.
With Tiger Chung Lee's expertise in the field of martial arts, you notice Gorilla Monsoon, quite obvious. No shoes, no boots. A bare feet with a little tape.
Don't know how they can do that, Gene. Tiger Chung Lee turns the tables here as he's got something, some kind of a foreign object that was thrown into the ring.
Boy, is that obvious. Wow.
There's that karate kick. Right, look out. Whoa, rams him right into the table.
No, no. No. Oh, my word.
Oh, come on. Animal
picture here in the Boston Garden.
There'll be a fire sale on that table tomorrow.
Referee trying to get it out of there in the meantime.
Oh, please.
So, oh, look at that. He pulled something out of his tights. Gave him a shot with it. Look at George not even acknowledging those shots to the back as he's enthralled by the turnbuckle. Chung Lee down once he's choking him in there. Three count, he got him.
Oh, is that a surprise? Was that a surprise?
Steele's got something out of his tights. He nailed him with it again.
Well, he hasn't completely tucked it away either. I don't know if our cameras can pick it up, but right along the... Oh!
Tiger Chung Lee has departed for the dressing room, and I don't blame him, as look at this individual go bananas. This guy's not playing with a full deck, Jim.
Oh, look at that ominous green tongue when he was facing us.
He needs a lot more psychiatric help.
He doesn't know where he's at.
Not a clue. Fans love him. There he goes after the referee. Let's go back and take a look at what went down here in the Boston Garden. The Animal now, after his favorite snack, the turnbuckle, he had something in his hand right there, Gene.
Oh, you can see it.
There it
That's
was.
That's it.
Went down, covered Tiger Chung Lee, got the 1-2-3 count. That's all she wrote, and you can bet your bottom dollar that the Chunger is happy to be out of this one. Another shot with that foreign object.
After the decision had been rendered by the referee, then look. George the Animal Steele goes to the turnbuckles, and Katie by the door. Watch out. George Steele, your winner from the Boston Garden.
This match is one fall with a 30-minute time limit. First from Oakland, California, weighing 248 pounds, former Canadian All-Star football player George Wells. And from San Francisco, California, weighing 258 pounds, Brutus Beefcake.
Whoops.
Once again, the luscious one, Johnny Valiant, not in attendance here in the Boston Garden to second his protege, Brutus Beefcake, and who's in for a rough, rough time with Mr. Wells, Gene.
Is he ever? We've seen George Wells come on in recent weeks and months, showing vast improvement, especially in the area of what this man can do with his feet and his legs.
Well, George has the capabilities, in my book, to beat anyone on any given evening. And Brutus Beefcake being no exception.
Oh, look at that. They say a picture is worth a thousand words. From San Francisco, California, Brutus Beefcake.
Well, for some 6 months here in the World Wrestling Federation, Gene, from parts unknown, and then out of the chute from San Francisco. Trying to tell us something, or?
I don't know. I'm sure there's some kind of a statement that is being made in a very subtle way by luscious Johnny Valiant.
I'm sure. Taking his time, trying to do a little psych job on Mr. Wells.
Brutus Beefcake, one of the most flamboyant wrestlers, I think, to ever hit the ring in many a year.
Absolutely true. And he's got a lot of charisma, Gene, and sometimes that acts in his favor.
But it can be, I would imagine, psychologically intimidating to an opponent. But I don't know if George Wells is going to buy that.
George Wells is a pretty well-experienced professional wrestler, and he might not get turned around that easily.
He is an experienced athlete as a football player. He knew how to win. He was the best at what he did in that particular sport. professional wrestling, he goes into it with the same kind of confidence because of the preparation and the knowledge.
I'm sure he could still be playing. Look at that beautiful arm drag.
See what I mean? Quick as a cat.
Yep. Still could be playing in the ranks of professional football, but chose the professional wrestling ring for his career and has delighted many a fan in doing so.
Well, I talked to George about that privately, and he contends he just didn't care to get wrapped up in a political system that included a fleet of coaches and 45 men on a roster.
Well, here he's his own managing, a self-employed independent contractor, can do pretty much what he wants to do, and at most times he does just that. Referee will have to break it here to end the ropes. George with a side headlock. Oh, Brutus with an elbow right into the short ribs, and another one. Nice forearm shot. Look out. Big Beal, George right up. Oh, nice shoulder block. Down for another one. Oh, drop deep kick again. Look at George waiting.
3 points, that's, and Brutus beat kick. I think very wisely.
Bailed out. He didn't want that number three for sure.
Seeks a little sanctuary on the exterior of this ring here at the Boston Garden this week.
Two beautiful short tackles.
My.
Delivered there.
Did you notice he was down on that 3-point stance? He even wanted more on Brutus Beefcake.
Boy, you know, when you do something long enough, there's no way to get it out of your system. Let's go back if we can and take a quick look at this.
Take a look at this. In
watch
slow motion, what is Beefcake trying to do?
Whoa!
Now you can see what a little crack block could do to a defensive back.
We're back to live action. Beefcake reluctant about the coming out of that corner. Now he's out there. Side headlock by Brutai. Wells won't stay in this too long. He doesn't have any growth on top of his head, so he'll be slipping out of there very shortly. It's tough to hold when a guy doesn't have any hair. Brutus in for the ride. Over the top. Another one over the top. There's George waiting for it again with that taco. And he caught him coming in.
Why does that fire up these fans? Jam-packed in the Boston Garden this week for this one-on-one bout. Wells really a favorite here.
Oh, he certainly is. What an ovation he got when he first came out. Made a lot of fans here in Beantown. And these are tough fans here, Gene.
Are they ever? They are some of the most electric, enthusiastic fans you're going to find in the World Wrestling Federation.
They're not wishy-washy. They either love you or they
hate
you.
That's right.
There's no in-between with them.
Oh, beautiful maneuver on the part of George Wells.
Nice duck under into that hammerlock. Really cinching it up, applying the pressure.
I'll tell you, the quickness of a big man like Wells is what really amazes me.
He's still young, Gene. That's where it comes from. Oh, you let him right outside. Beefcake tried to get out of that hammerlock by running, and George ran him right between the ropes.
Oh, my.
Both men outside.
Here we go. Both men outside of the ring. Brutus Beefcake and George Wells. Oh, they're locked up now.
Nice shot by Wells. Oh, a headbutt.
Oh, my.
He caught him with a beauty. Wells now going to roll. Went to ram him, and he got shoved off right at the last second. What a forceful blow on that arm and shoulder. George is down.
Now he could have blown a shoulder out. There's a boot to the upper torso.
I don't know what the referee was counting, Gene. Both of those guys were out there an awful long time.
Both of them. Wells is hurt. George Wells is obviously hurt. I don't know if he's going to make it back in.
He's still down on the
concrete. Beefcake, come on.
There he goes. Brutus out there once more.
He could have had the match if he would have just stayed in the ring.
He doesn't want to count out. He wants to beat this guy decisively. Took a hammerlock and is forcing him right back in the ring with it.
Wells is hurt. Make no mistake about it. I've seen enough of him. I know that he is hurt. He is hurt badly.
Well, he rammed the point of that shoulder right into that steel post at full speed ahead. And Brutus going to work on it now.
What a dislocation, a separation, a broken clavicle.
Boy,
it could
so
be a number of injuries.
And when you're hot and perspiring like George is right now, it's hard to tell how seriously you are hurt. Tomorrow morning, about 9 o'clock, you'll know.
Going to work now. Left arm and shoulder. Brutus Beefcake going to ram him in again. Wow.
That's that very same shoulder. Beefcake, this one I will compliment. Beefcake, tenaciously being very much aware of the vulnerable spot on the physique of George Wells.
Certainly is taking advantage of the situation. Look at this now. He's wrapping it up. Going to drop off the apron with it. Oh, my God.
Wells in deep, deep trouble here in the Boston Garden as Brutus Beefcake unloading everything on that left arm and shoulder. Relentless. Of course, luscious Johnny Valiant certainly has instilled that in him. Wells grimacing in pain. Down for the cover. One count, two. He won't get him. Brutus looking a little bit surprised. You're not going to beat George Wells with that kind of a cover. Wells got to try to get to his feet here, Gene. Much better position when he's standing, because right now he's taking a tremendous pummeling at the hands of Brutus Beefcake.
One thing I noticed, Beefcake still wearing that very controversial gear on the hands and forearms. It'll be so easy to tuck a foreign object in there.
or a lunch or anything.
Yes.
Right now he's making him pay with this chicken wing that he had his foot tied up in and tremendous leverage applied. Wells is in deep, deep, deep trouble. Comes up with a right hand. Not a whole lot behind it.
I reckon the eyes will stop him though in short order.
In a hurry. And Wells once again at the mercy of Brutus Beefcake.
Shot to the windpipe. No question of that one.
Can't beat him that way.
No. I believe he gave a little skullcracker.
Made his ears ring a little bit there. Wells not being able to put any pressure on that left arm and shoulder whatsoever.
Oh, there's a shot to the side of the head, the forearm. Look at these two men on our knees exchanging blows. Wells. Heavy kick. Go down to two for nail. George Wells seems to be mounting the offensive at this point in time.
Wells with a headbutt. Oh. Brutus Beefcake on Green Street.
Oh, look at Beefcake holding his head. He got hurt. Oh, reverse crescent kick. Oh.
Wells with a big right hand mounting the offense. Irish whip now. Brutus coming off. One right to the lower abdomen.
That one down low enough.
Oh! Head scissors didn't get it, Gene.
I'll tell you what, though. Brutus Beefcake, though, he got nailed because he's going to know it in the form of cauliflower ears.
I think Wells was worried about hurting that arm some more on the way down on that particular move. But Wells with the upper hand right now. Irish whip. Wow, he did that with the injured shoulder. I can't believe he did that, Gene.
That's more of the football. Three-point stance for George Wells. He's lining up for this Beefcake.
Dangerous over, look out.
Oh, what a dive. Followed by a knee.
He's hooking the leg here and part of the tights, too.
Was going for the big move.
Well, he gave it everything, Gene, in one desperation type move. That big tackle into the corner, but
Brutus was deep off the farm after that one.
Absolutely.
The winner of the match, Brutus Beefcake.
Arrogant, proud, and a winner this week in the Boston Garden. Brutus Beefcake.
Brutus, a hard-fought victory. Let's go back and take a look at the big mistake by George Wells.
And was this a gigantic mistake? What timing on the part of Beefcake? Oh, Wells hit hard.
Beefcake was playing possum there, Gene. Look at this maneuver now. High knee right to the back of the neck. Down hooks the leg. And a bit of the tights as well and gets a three count. Hard fought victory for Brutus Beefcake. He knew that he was in a matchup here in the Boston Garden this week.
Flair with the big guys. Brutus Beefcake right there, your winner from the Boston Garden here of the World Wrestling Federation. Wow.
This match is one fall with a 30-minute time limit. First from parts unknown, the mysterious Mr. X. His opponent from Culebra, Puerto Rico, weighing 242 pounds, Pedro Morales.
Pedro Morales getting a big hand here in the Boston Garden.
As he has done so. And many times before, is a former Intercontinental and I believe World Wrestling Federation heavyweight champion.
Not only that, Gene, at one time Pedro Morales was probably the only man in professional wrestling ever to hold the Intercontinental title, the World Wrestling Federation tag team title, and the championship, the World Wrestling Federation heavyweight championship. At one time, he held all three belts.
Simultaneous.
Well, he had to give up the World Wrestling Federation tag team title because it was illegal at that time under the rules of the World Wrestling Federation to hold both titles. But he was winner of all three. Not too many men are going to accomplish that in their career.
I don't think you'll ever see that again.
No, I doubt it. A household word in the world of professional wrestling, Pedro Morales.
Well, what a tremendous personality on this man.
Outstanding individual and represented the World Wrestling Federation the first class, as does the current reigning heavyweight champion, Hulk Hogan.
Mr. X a little reluctant to get into the ring, and I can't say as I blame him. There he goes, slapping those hands together.
Says, I'm ready for any kind of action, baby. And he means it.
That is action with a capital A.
And his coup de grace, the Boston Crab, Gene. What a more fitting place to apply it than here in the Boston Garden.
What a beautiful day as we flew over Cape Cod into the Logan International Airport here in Boston with the sailboats.
If you
out of the beautiful Atlantic.
Sand dunes and salt sea air. This is the place to be. Mr. X complaining about pulling on the mask, but Morales says far too many scruples to do that.
Now this is going to become frustrating for Morales in short order. And this like a guy likes to get in there and get it done.
Doesn't like to waste any time. Comes prepared, knows exactly what he wants to do. Side headlock now by Mr. X. And he's going for the ride. Morales drops down in front over the top X. Oh, look at that high hipper. Right up. Oh, what a high slam.
What a flurry and a pot of Pedro Morales. There's one man that was at the receiving end.
He wants time out.
Does he ever? Boy, that lower back has got to hurt. Timeout.
There
he's calling for
the signal. There is no timeout in professional wrestling, Mr. X.
I am sorry.
Referee counting, but X not wanting to return as he was stunned by those two tremendously executed moves by former champion Pedro Morales. Mr. X going around to the steps. Usually he'll call in anywhere he can, but he's heading for the steps. Crowd getting on his case here in the Boston Garden as the World Wrestling Federation bringing you more action and excitement.
Thousands on their feet, clapping their hands, and Mr. X cannot contend with it. What is he going to do, walk out?
Highly unlikely. He'd like to give us that impression, but I'm sure he won't. Too much money at stake, Gene.
Walk away from a very good payday. He's not going to do that, though. No.
You know, for every purse, there's a winner's share and a loser's share, and they split the money, should be a draw or double disqualification, something of that nature, where neither man wins. But if you walk out of a match, you
forget
get
it.
Zero, zilch, nothing. Your opponent gets all the prize money for that particular bout. Side headlock now by Mr. X, trying to find some way to control this guy. No way. Nice maneuvers. He takes him over. Look at that. Morales right out the front door. Comes up with a beautiful hammerlock.
Well, I'll tell you what. Mr. X, Gorilla Monsoon, getting a reprieve after reprieve.
Getting very frustrated, Gene.
Oh, no.
Fans at ringside getting on his case pretty good.
Are they ever?
And Morales waiting patiently. Six. He's up to a six count now, Gene. X wants him to step back.
Collared elbow hookup. Morales into the corner. Mr. X with a forearm. That was a glancing blow. That didn't fly at all.
Oh, that left hand. Wow.
X trying to cover up. But did Morales nail him? And boy, you can see the frustration right there.
X complaining about that big roundhouse left. That is not an illegal maneuver.
Wait a minute.
He'll be back. He'd like to go, but
would he ever?
These guys are out here for one reason, Gene, and that's to make money. That's going to make him come back.
I'd like to know who that man is.
Well, I don't know why on earth anyone would want to put a mask on. They are the most uncomfortable things you can imagine. You can't see, you can't breathe, you can't hear. Beats me to death. Why'd they do it? Look out, knee.
Wow.
Right on the shin bone.
Was that some kind of a move?
Nice way to fracture that tibia. Mr. X might as well get a chair and stay out there for a while. The referee's not going to count him out, Gene. That's obvious. So just get a chair and take a breather.
And I guarantee you, one man that is not happy by the presence of Mr. X on the outside of the ring is Pedro Morales.
None whatsoever. This guy has come here for one reason. That's for action. And he's not getting it because this guy keeps bailing out. And the referee is the one who's at fault here for letting him do it. That's why the ring has ropes on it, Gene, to keep you inside. Of course, Mr. X doesn't feel that way.
Well, he's been going out on his own choosing, of his own volition.
Max Morales into the corner. Another glancing blow. That left cut. Oh, an eye gouge. That'll slow down, Pedro.
Oh, very low with that boot.
X with the whip now. Morales into the ropes. Oh, nice clothesline by Mr. X.
What a clothesline.
Down for the cover. One count. Two, that's all. Morales stunned by that clothesline. X going to try it again, maybe. Morales ducked underneath it. X right over the top.
Oh, watch out.
Look out.
Hold on.
Comic drop.
Oh, he's going to get no mercy from Morales.
Oh, that big oh. He did a 360 in midair.
Oh, my.
Up for the big slam. Look out. Boston Crab coming up.
Ironically enough, in Boston, Mass.
There it is.
He can't hold out. Oh, Morales. Listen to this. Boston Crab.
Pedro Morales finally got him to stay in the ring long enough to put a couple of moves together.
Here's the winner with the Boston Crab, Pedro Morales.
Pedro Morales, big smile on his face. Fans giving him thumbs up sign. Let's go back and take a look at how he polished off Mr. X.
Now
watch this left.
Boy.
Wow. The beginning of the end right there, Jim.
What a shot to the midsection. Pedro Morales subsequently picking up Mr. X. Body slam, and it was just elementary from here on out. Easily going over the top.
The icing on the cake as he sits back Mr. X giving the sign with the hands. That's enough for me. Morales on the victory here in the Boston Garden this week.
Come on, Paula, I won't hurt you.
This match is one fall with a 60-minute time limit.
I don't think we're going to get much of a ring announcement for this one. These two guys are ready for action. Gorilla Monsoon with Gene Okerlund here at ringside in the Boston Garden. And this vendetta is about to go down, Gene.
All the refereeing got to be played. Piper and Orndorff. Bell is solid. Piper on the offensive at the outset of this match. Orton comes back. Oh!
Orndorff now unloading with those big rights. And Piper, look at that beautiful single leg takedown. Takes him down to the canvas. These guys are out to maim each other.
Oh, look at the punishment being dealt out right now.
There goes Piper and Orndorff right after. Look out, atomic drop.
Whoa.
Batten down the hatches.
Caught a gun on top of the table over there, the timekeeper.
Oh, he nailed it with something, Gene, a microphone stand. And he hit Paul a hard shot. Piper now with the upper hand, look out, not the table.
Whoa, oh,
this is mayhem.
This place has gone bananas.
Pandemonium here in the Boston Garden as Orndorff off the top turnbuckle. Tremendous elbow.
You know, when I talked to Piper prior to the match, he was so confident, he was so cocky.
Boy, he wants a piece of this guy, Gene, the worst way. Look at him. Some very derogatory statements made by the Hot Rod.
These guys hate each other.
Absolutely.
I mean, there is bitter, bitter hatred. I don't think I've ever seen anything quite like it, Gorilla Monsoon, really.
In the longer ranks of the World Wrestling Federation, never has there been such a vendetta as this between Piper and Mr. Wonderful. And it's all going to be settled possibly right here in the Boston Garden this week.
Oh, knee to the forehead of Roddy Piper.
Oh. Oh, poked him right in the eye. Boy, that'll slow you down. I don't care how big and bad you are.
It looks to me like Piper's going to need the respite also. Boy, he got nailed time and time again by Paul Orndorff.
He's not sure exactly where he is. Look out.
Oh, to the right by Piper.
Delivered it halfway across the ring.
Oh, look at him. He's staggering around like a drunk sailor.
He's still feeling the wrath of the onslaught by Orndorff early on. Oh, double karate shot right to the throat.
Don't think for a minute. People want to underestimate Roddy Piper. When it comes to his expertise in the ring, believe you me, he is a world-class wrestler all the way.
Absolutely true.
One of the 10 best in the world today, I'd have to say.
I'd have to agree. Piper now whipping Orndorff in. Look out, back to the sunset flip. Can he get him over? No. He got a handful of tights.
Piper just about lost his drawers on that one.
And there's Whoop. Phil down. He hasn't pulled him up yet.
Whoop.
Piper going to work now on Mr. Wonderful.
Oh, boot to the side of the head. Orndorff is down.
He doesn't realize those tights are down.
About a half moon out tonight.
The referee could reach over there and pull him up.
It would be the gentlemanly thing to do.
Suplex from the outside. Piper trying to set it up. Slipped over the top. And a nice sunset roll up. One, two, no. Two count only. Piper wasn't even sure.
And he got Orndorff in the eyes again with a couple of fingers.
He turned around and asked the referee, did you count me out? He wasn't even sure.
He doesn't know. He hasn't even pulled his tights up.
Nope.
Fully yet. What did he do? Just slap the referee?
I think he did. You can't do that.
A little pushing and shoving going on. The referee, I think, is doing the right thing here. Knee lift.
Beautiful knee lift. Well executed by the Hot Rod.
Referee can't take any guff off Piper. He's got to establish control right away.
Orndorff in sleeper hold by Rott. Right in the center of the ring. Orndorff's fighting it.
That is a Singapore sleeper.
Crowd on its feet. Look out, Orndorff slipping now.
That's good night.
He's got him right in the center of the ring.
He is fading very quickly. Piper doing the right thing, going right down with him. Pretty soon that body is going to collapse.
No matter how powerful you are, once you stop the flow of blood to the brain, the lights go out. Look at the color.
When Orndorff wakes up from this one, he's going to be a very disappointed individual.
Roddy's got it slapped on just about in the center of the ring. Looks very bad right now for Mr. Wonderful.
Oh, it's all over. I guarantee you, it is all over.
Arm limp.
I've seen sleeper holds before, Gorilla Monsoon. He is out. He is out.
Wouldn't surprise me, Gene. This guy's got so much guts. Oh, look at that.
What the?
Both arms straight up in the air. He's fighting it.
Where did that come from?
Orndorff fighting it, manages to get to his feet. Throws a Hot Rod in and they collide head to head. What tremendous guts on the part of Paul Orndorff as he fought that sleeper hold. Roddy can't believe it.
Well, I thought it was all over for Orndorff.
Boy, it certainly looked bad, Gene. Piper can't believe it. Look, he's looking around in amazement.
What absolutely tremendous, tremendous resiliency on the part of Paul Orndorff. I am shocked. Wow. Roundhouse right to the side of the head that rocks Mr. Wonderful. Still on his feet, however.
Oh, another beauty. Look at Orndorff. Manages to stay on his feet.
Boy, that is pride right there.
He's reaching down for something extra down inside. Nice side mirror takes him over. This will give him a breather. This will give him a chance to come together.
Turn it on!
Referee's got to watch for the choke here. Piper not wanting to stay in there very long. Rolls up over the top. Where's the count here? He's flat on his back. Two count. Oh, what a bridge.
Look at
that slide.
Two.
No.
Oh, how close. How close.
Beautiful backslide by Mr. Wonderful. Almost caught Hot Rod as he's throwing those rights again.
But look at Piper tee it up.
Oh, look at this. Both of them backwards. Over the top rope, down to the concrete.
Knocked the table down. It could have been very seriously injured.
Both men slugging it out now.
Outside of the ring.
Look out. Piece of steel, microphone stand. Oh, Piper got it. Right across the back of the neck.
I can't believe he's still standing.
Rams him into the ring apron.
Piper staggered by the punishment.
He doesn't know where he is.
This has got to be...
Oh, referee's calling for the bell here.
What happened?
One or both of them were counted out, Gene.
What happened?
Look out. Oh! Pearl Harbor job from behind.
Oh,
he nailed
the referee. Roddy Piper has done it again. He'll never get away with this.
He'll be fined heavily for that one.
That's going to cost him $5,000 if it costs him a nickel.
Absolutely, you cannot do that. Orndorff going out after him. Slugging it out now in the corridors. And there goes Piper and Orndorff right on his case.
They're going to take this one back to the locker rooms. Maybe out into the parking lot. Out of the streets of Boston. This week. Oh, what a war continuing on between Roddy Piper.
There's a tear. Oh! Pandemonium broken loose here in the Boston Garden.
Oh!
And this vendetta was not settled.
Once again, I don't think we have heard the end of this story. Both men counted out at the Boston Garden. Rowdy Piper and Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff in World Wrestling Federation action.
Unbelievable.
Ladies and gentlemen, the referee has counted both men out of the ring. A double count out. This match is one fall with a 30-minute time limit. First from Italy, weighing 240 pounds, Salvatore Palomo. And approaching the ring from Sarasota, Florida, weighing 247 pounds, the Macho Man, Randy Savage.
Gorilla Monsoon here at ringside in the Boston Garden with my companion and longtime friend, Mean Gene Okerlund.
Where is he? There he is.
There he is.
The Macho Man. Randy Savage, has he been cutting a swath through the World Wrestling Federation as of late?
Hottest piece of property in all of professional wrestling today. Just an unbelievable individual.
Without a question of a doubt. Talk about flamboyance. He is it personified.
Commands the respect of fans wherever he goes, Gene, and he wants it and he gets it. Because he does some unreal things. Not too warm a welcome.
Let me ask you a question. What do you think that robe would sell for across the counter?
Oh, minimum $15,000 minimum, Jane. I haven't purchased a robe in a long, long time, but that's a minimum 15 big ones right there. Of course, Salvatore's outfit might run into some heavy numbers as well. Salvatore Palomo did not get a very warm reception here in the Boston Garden, Gene.
No, I don't quite understand that. Palomo trying to get to Savage, the referee in the middle. You know, Salvatore still has a little trouble with the English language, and I can understand that. Lord knows I would have a little trouble with the Italian language.
Well, when he first came to the World Wrestling Federation, he was a big card here in the Boston Garden, Jim. And was greeted with standing ovations.
What is this?
Macho Man taking exception to someone at ringside here. In fact, he's taking exception to everyone at ringside.
And I think the feeling's mutual.
Obviously, it is.
Fans really starting to get on the Macho Man's case.
Well, doing some of the things he does, there's no way that he would win the respect of the fans, Jane.
Absolutely not. Now, what is this?
Down on all fours and slips right out underneath the bottom rope.
Well, look at the frustration as we see Randy Macho Man Savage walk around ringside this week here in the World Wrestling Federation. The frustration, though, of Salvatore, but almost second to none.
Macho Man extremely agile and quick. Probably much quicker than Salvatore Palomo, who is no slouch in the speed department himself. But nice. He's going to have to take a back seat this week.
Nice clean break on the part of Palomo. I wonder if the Macho Man would have done that.
Highly unlikely. Palomo with a nice sit out and counter. Surprise the Macho Man. Macho Man does not like the photographer at ringside, Gene.
I believe that photographer, by the way, is from Japan.
International flair, as always, here in the World Wrestling Federation. We get international coverage at every major attraction put on by the World Wrestling Federation, and Boston Garden, no exception.
Well, I'm certain he is all part of the Nippon Communications Group. That is a newspaper, radio, and television in
Japan. Boy, they go everywhere. They're everywhere. Nice maneuver by Beloma here. He got him over. Hook the leg now.
Oh, my. Salvatore turning it on.
Macho Man trying to do a little psych job here on Salvatore Belomo.
I think he's trying to bait him.
Possibly.
Think he's trying to set him up.
He's taking a hike now. Many, many signs in attendance this week at the Boston Garden.
Give me a break.
Referee Danny Davis, it looks like he needs a haircut, trying to maintain some semblance of order in this matchup.
I wish I could say that about myself.
Nice
Paul
Nelson.
Nelson.
Macho Man slipped behind very nicely here. Let's see how Salvatore Belomo is going to counter this. A number of ways to come out. Reverse it into a full Nelson of your own.
Who is the full Nelson named after? Do you know?
Full Nelson. Named after probably.
I know now, so go ahead.
Okay. Art Nelson, I would assume.
Nelson Swagler.
Nelson Swagler. Boy, you're going way back in time now, Gene. Nelson
that goes
Swagler.
Back. That goes back to the early 1920s.
That's really out of the archives.
Macho Man. I don't know what he's doing over there in that corner. He kind of. He regroups a lot, you might say.
Yes, he does.
Oh, step over with the arm bar. The wrist. Oh, beautiful counter on the part. There's hair. And just that quickly, Salvatore Belomo down on the canvas. Referee detected it. Called the Macho Man. Good job of officiating.
Absolutely. Danny Davis showing him he's not going to put up with any of that garbage. He's going to get right on his case. Nice to see that here in the World Wrestling Federation.
Davis a real pro. I'll tell you what, I've respected his officiating talents.
One of the guys who used that full Nelson to great advantage many, many years ago, Gene, Yukon Eric.
The great Yukon Eric.
Long since passed away.
I'm certain that hold has been around for a long, long time. They just never tacked a name onto it.
Yes, definitely.
Finally, somebody came along who was a master. All of a sudden, it's a full Nelson.
Yeah. Or a half Nelson. Or a three-quarter Nelson.
They could all be effective.
There goes Belomo out onto the concrete here in the Boston Garden.
Oh, I believe he hurt his...
Came right down on that left shin.
He hurt his shin. What is this with the Macho Man?
Knee
lift
right
in the barricade. Oh. This guy is absolutely brutal.
Went right out after him and administered that extra bit of punishment. Belomo staggering around out there as the Macho Man, he's gone out after him again. Look at him sneaking around there. Just like a dog. Look
you
at that.
You've got to be kidding me.
He caught up with him. Sal had no idea where he was. Look out.
Oh, no.
Rammed him once again into that steel barricade surrounding the ring here in the Boston Garden.
And the Macho Man proud of it.
Belomo in deep trouble. Randy Savage stops at nothing to get victory. Look out, Salvatore going up.
Oh my, not again. Just that quickly, Randy Savage back outside of the ring and he's on that photographer.
Oh, he's got that photographer now.
He is on his case. He should be paying attention to this one-on-one bout. What is he going to try to do? Oh, and a shot to the forehead that rocks Belomo.
Belomo counters with the right hand and another one. Oh, there's an elbow by the Macho Man. Rams him into the wooden steps here leading to the ring. Macho Man just bailing back in time to break that count. Could have been a double count out there very easily.
Admonishment on the part of the referee to Randy Savage.
Oh, small package by Belomo. Very close.
The element of surprise. Belomo, I thought, just about had the Macho Man. Was that quick?
Very, very nice small package. Had he hooked the other leg with his right leg, Might have got a three count. Savage stunned, now backs into the corner. Oh, an eye rake. Wow, that'll slow you down in a hurry. Whatever kind of offense Paloma had going for him, you forget about it now.
Oh, look at these punches. Look at this. Series of lefts to the jaw. Now back to the eyes and the hair. I can't believe it.
He's got all that tape on his hands too, Gene, which makes it doubly effective.
Oh. Look at Paloma all hung up in the ropes. Savage putting the boots to the Native of Italy.
Paloma in a whole heap of trouble this week in the World Wrestling Federation at the hands of the Macho Man, who just grabs anything he can get a hold of. Here, a handful of hair. Oh, another shot as Paloma, once again, his pro body down on the concrete. Macho Man, look out!
What's up?
Oh! Double hammer to the back of the neck of Salvatore Paloma.
Will not get back in that ring. That was a double sledge coming off that top turnbuckle. Spat had to be 18, 20, maybe more up in the air.
I don't know anyone else today in the entire wrestling world that does that, because it is such a dangerous maneuver, Jim.
Well, sometimes something is going to happen, and Savage is going to take himself
right out of it. Clothesline.
Very unique clothesline. He really...
he waited for him and dropped right with him. Power slams him right in the center of the ring. Look out. Macho Man going to the outside once again on the top turnbuckle. Watch for that patented flying elbow. There it comes.
Oh. Holy cow.
Hooks the leg. One, two, he got him.
And that'll be it. The coup de grace. High flying Randy Macho Man Savage. Salvatore Paloma is hurt.
Macho Man Randy Savage really giving a lesson to Salvatore Paloma this week.
The winner of the match, Randy Macho Man Savage.
You know, Gorilla Monsoon, I want to go back in time and take a look at that phenomenal move that Randy Savage has off that top rope when he gets an opponent outside of the ring.
There
now
it
take
is.
Take a look at how high he goes. Up in the air. Pow!
Most dangerous and unorthodox move in professional wrestling today. One miscalculation on the part of the Macho Man, it could terminate his career immediately.
I've never seen anything like it. Randy Macho Man Savage getting the nuke this week here on the World Wrestling Federation.
This match is one fall with a 45-minute time limit. First, from Charlotte, North Carolina, weighing 236 pounds, Quick Draw, Rick McGraw. And from the Double Cross Ranch in Amarillo, Texas, weighing 260 pounds, Terry Funk.
The wild man from Texas, Terry Funk, Gorilla Monsoon here at ringside with my colleague, Gene Okerlund. And this is a, how can you trust a guy from the Double Cross Ranch, Gene?
Well, I'll tell you, I bet it was spread, as they say down in West Texas. He's about, oh, I'd say 18 miles just south of Amarillo. Right high atop the cliffs of the Paladura Canyon.
Oh, how exciting.
Got thousands and thousands of acres.
Well, he should have. He's made plenty of money.
As he ever.
Of professional wrestling
as he ever.
Did his entire family.
Of course, his father, the great Dory Funk Sr. Brother Dory Funk Jr.
That's correct. Quick Draw, Rick McGraw. Got a new hairstyle, Gene. Looks good.
Rick looks fantastic.
Yes, he does.
Nice bronzed body.
Came back after much adversity.
He is a physical fitness junkie, as you can see.
Whoa, look at that. Funk slips right out underneath that bottom rope. Almost went head first down to the concrete. Now think about this a little bit.
When Terry Funk entered the ring, he had a branding iron along with him in his hand.
Well, we've seen him use that, Jim. I've seen him use that. Beats an opponent and squashes that branding iron down into their chest, which should be outlawed.
Big heavy forearm on the part of Terry Funk. I don't know, the way I saw it, that's perfectly legal.
The forearm or the branding iron? Right?
The forearm. Oh, the okay. Branding iron, no.
Absolutely no place for that in the world of professional wrestling. Oh, fire plug has got a lot of steam. Look at that nice muscle there. Funk got hung up on a top turnbuckle and top rope.
Oh, did he get jarred? That back of his has got to be in three different pieces right now.
Decided discretion the better part. Took a little hike ski for himself. Imagine 20 years from now, some of these guys taking these tremendous falls on this concrete floor, Gene. I know what it feels like. That's why I left the ring.
Oh, they're gonna be hurt.
Absolutely. Have no idea. Nice shoulder block. Oh, Funk drives him down hard into the ropes once more. Nice counter.
Beautifully done, Rick McCall. Body slam.
Scoop slam by the little fire plug. Funk checking out all the parts. Make sure they're still working.
It's inventory time in Boston. This facility, one of the greats in the World Wrestling Federation.
Hotbed.
Is it ever? The Celtics, the Bruins, professional franchises along with the World Wrestling Federation. In here on an ongoing basis.
Another reversal by McGraw sends Funk in. Went for it again. Another high scoop slam. That's twice.
Well, veteran Terry Funk is going to figure this out pretty quick.
He's kicking at those ropes. He's upset. McGraw, I'm sure he's enough of a professional to know you can't go to the well too many times.
Terry Funk, quite a name in Hollywood. He's been in a number of motion pictures.
Oh, he did some tremendous stuff. Yeah.
Television series or two. Did Paradise Alley sometime back with Sylvester Stallone.
Oh, there's a reversal now by Funk. Coming in hard. Whoa! Shoulder first. Hard to tell whether he connected with the steel post or not. We'll tell in a minute. Yes, he did.
Oh, did he ever? You could just tell. That's body language.
Absolutely. Can't feel it. We can only see it, so we have to wait to see it.
What is this?
Shoulder breaker. Yes. Down hooks a leg, one count only. Funk got out of there in a hurry. I believe he's underestimated quick draw, Jim.
Gotta believe it. Walking into this ring, he was so cocky, he had a little dialogue going with fans at ringside and forgot about Rick McGraw. Don't do it, Rick. Don't do it. This guy's a veteran.
And a snake. Texas Rattler. Clean break.
Clean break. Nicely done. Very nicely done. Tell you the truth, I didn't expect that from Mr. Funk.
Well, I think he's setting him up for something here, Gene. Offered a hand, a friendship, and now a clean break.
Look at this.
Does he know his wrestling?
Oh,
duck under into that beautiful standing top wrist lock. Nice counter
look at
by McGraw.
Oh, did he come back beautifully?
Funk to the ropes. Will constitute the break. He's setting this youngster up, Gene.
Well, we got a clean break by both men, McGraw and Funk. Terry Funk repeatedly going over to McGraw and offering him his hand. That should have been done at the beginning of the match because right now it's all out war.
Look at this beautiful maneuver. Funk using the ropes to his advantage. Take Rick out over the top. He said, no, I don't want to do anything. Here's my hand. Shake it. I'm surprised he didn't let him go up the steps first, Gene. Funk is setting him up.
Well, if I have ever seen a setup job, this is it.
Well, Rick has been around wrestling for a long time. If he doesn't see it, I'll be very surprised.
I think he sees it. You notice he hasn't shook hands with the Amarillo, Texas native.
Side headlock now by Terry Funk. Nice switch around backside. The hammerlock up with the leg. Nice kick out by McGraw. There's the hand again. Saying, what do you want from me? Your reputation precedes you always, Terry. Look at this, Jim.
And I'll tell you what, Terry Funk arrived in the World Wrestling Federation with some pretty impressive credentials. He has lived up to them.
Certainly has. He's building quite a reputation. Another clean break. Very unusual. However, only a deceiving move. As everyone knows the characteristics of Terry Funk.
Side headlock.
He said to the referee, look, see how nice I applied that? Didn't grab any hair or anything.
That's something you probably got to explain periodically to the referee. I mean,
look at that. Did you see that? That's an automatic disqualification in my book. Got away with it. Screaming at McGraw to get up. McGraw is in agony right now.
Is this guy brutal?
Look out. There he goes.
Oh!
He hit hard on the concrete.
Did he ever? Camera's right there on top of it. That's our number six camera, I believe.
Seven. Number seven, I was informed.
Thank you.
Six is being isolated right at the moment. Funk going out now after McGraw. No, he's going out after some ringsider. Funk better. Well,
I believe I detected the chant of JYD.
McGraw in deep, deep trouble here in the Boston Garden as he hit that concrete.
Wow, he hit it hard. When you're flying through the air with your legs up, you just cannot break that fall.
There's no way. No way, shape, or form. Funk challenging the entire Boston Garden.
And a capacity crowd.
In the meantime, McGraw trying to make his way back up to the ring. Moving very slowly. Referee Danny Davis trying to keep back. Give McGraw a chance to get back into the ring.
Wow.
Headbutt.
Is that a headbutt?
Yep. And another one. McGraw just about out of it. There he goes. It's not the place to be, Gene, out there on the concrete.
Not at all. Funk will always retain the upper hand as long as he's got Rick McGraw down on his cement floor here at the Boston Garden.
Gonna take a lot for Rick to mount any kind of offense following this brutal attack. Referees count up to, I don't know, seven or eight. Funk keeps breaking it. Not going to give this youngster a chance to come in on his own.
Watch
for
this.
Sure.
Watch this, Gorilla.
Suplex from the outside. Whoa, was that executed well?
Absolutely jarring suplex by Terry Funk to McGraw. Kick out after a two count. Was that close?
Two and three quarters. Look at Funk. Wow, another headbutt right to the back of the head.
That's a move patented by the Junkyard Dog.
Certainly is. Irish whip now. McGraw, I don't know where he got the steam to go in there. Come up with a sunset flip.
Oh, he's got him. No, he doesn't.
Close, but no cigar.
Only in horseshoes and hand grenades.
Snapmare takes McGraw over once more. Funk got really surprised by that sunset flip. No one there.
McGraw quickly checking out, and Funk lands on his posterior.
Atomic drop. Whoa.
Oh, my. Oh,
upside down, head first. Came down head first down to the concrete.
He could be hurt. Here comes McGraw after Terry Funk. into the barricade. Outside of the ring, look at these two men go at it tooth and nail.
Payback time. Of course, he's got a lot more to pay back. McGraw looking for a suplex of his own. Got him up. A beauty.
Alouette brought this
up
capacity.
Number one, no.
Crowd of its feet.
Side headlock now by Terry Funk. McGraw doesn't want to stay in that. Shoots him off immediately. Head to head they hit, Gene. Look at Funk. Doesn't know. He can't hold it up. Down he went.
He tried. Lord knows he tried.
Well, he did a couple little dance steps in there for us. But
did you see those legs hanging down like a couple of rubber bands? He was out of it.
I think McGraw got the worst of that confrontation.
Somebody might get split open on that collision.
Boy, they hit chin to chin almost. Look at this, staggering backwards with him. Can he hold him? Yes. Both men a little the worse for wear here. Elbow drop connects with nothing but the canvas. But Funk right back there again with another quick slam. That one caught him partially.
Yeah, but it didn't catch him where it would do any good.
Oh, picks him up in an airplane spin. McGraw going around. Beautiful airplane spin. What's he going to do with him?
I think he was going to try to back body splash the man.
He didn't get it, Gene.
He was out of gas.
Yeah, he didn't get it. High cross body. Down hooks legs. One. That's all. McGraw doesn't have enough energy left, I don't think, to put it together. Sleeper. Terry Funk's patented sleeper.
And he executes that particular hole like no other.
Absolutely not. He cinches it up. He's got those thin forearms, so he's able to wrap it up very tightly. And if McGraw doesn't make it to the ropes here, he's a goner.
It'll be all over. Referee right on top of the action, checking.
Checking if there's any sign of life left.
There is.
There goes.
There is it.
There's the bell.
Call a match. Terry Funk with the sleeper on Rick McGraw. He's not going to let go.
He's going to have to let go. He'll get fined and they'll reverse the decision. Hope he doesn't bring that branding iron into the ring, Gene. They'll reverse the decision. Hope he doesn't bring that branding iron into the ring, Gene. He's also got to bring this man back to consciousness.
All right, now, McGraw is in a comatose state.
Well, he cut the supply of oxygen to the brain, which made the lights go out. And until he does some work on a carotid artery, a little rub of some kind to get that blood flowing once more. Look, there's that branding iron.
Now he's threatening referee Dan Davis.
Dan, no! Don't let him do
that. No, come on. Please.
Oh, give me a break.
Oh. This is ridiculous. Absolutely ridiculous.
Referee should never allow that to take place. As chant goes out once more, JYD. McGraw now brought back to a state of consciousness.
Look at him!
Boy, I'll tell you, Terry Funk not enduring himself to the fans here.
Here's your winner, Terry Funk.
Funk did it with the sleeper Gorilla Monsoon. If that wasn't enough, the humiliation. Whoa, wait a minute.
Oh, McGraw's after that branding iron. He's got it. And Funk bailing out in a hurry. Terry Funk having trouble here at ringside in a Boston Garden, trying to find the right passageway to get back to the locker room. In the meantime, quick draw, Rick McGraw standing in the center of the ring with that double cross branding iron. Let's go back and take a look.
We've got it.
At that sleeper hold, Gene.
Well, I'll tell you what, he executes this one to perfection. McGraw comes off the ropes. High cross body. shortened up there. Two count only.
Watch this now as he gets caught coming off the ropes here.
Just that quickly.
Spun him right around.
Talk about positioning. Funk put it together so quick, McGraw had no chance.
That's the experience coming through the years and years and years in the gymnasium. And he applies the dreaded sleeper and is victorious here in the Boston Garden.
This is a special tag team attraction. One fall with a 1 hour time limit. First, team number one from Osaka, Japan, weighing 253 pounds, Mr. Fuji. His partner from Sunset Beach, Hawaii, weighing 267 pounds, the Magnificent Morocco. Team number two, soon to be approaching the ring, from Honolulu, Hawaii, weighing 235 pounds, Ricky Steamboat. And his partner from Charlotte, North Carolina, weighing 280 pounds, the Junkyard Dog.
Is gonna go nuts.
Jam packed here.
Oh!
Here they come!
Here they come! Oh!
Rilla Monsoon here in ringside with my colleague Gene Okerlund in the jam packed Boston. It's going to get underway right away.
Hall of Fame. Steamboat trying to choke Mr. Fuji.
He certainly is, Gene. He's paying him back.
You recall what happened in front of a national television audience when Morocco and Fuji double team Steamboat and choked him. One of the most humiliating things I have ever eyewitnessed.
Certainly was, and with his own sash, he was choked, left hanging there, coming to his rescue, the Junkyard Dog, and this is payback time. The Dragon, take a look at him. What an impressive individual.
And Junkyard Dog, no slouch by any stretch of the imagination.
Fuji rammed into his own partner. And the Dragon goes out.
Oh, now it's Steamboat of Morocco outside of the ring. Fuji and Junkyard Dog inside. Pelham and Pandemonium. Tag team action for the World Wrestling Federation I-Rate.
He's pulling out all the stops, Gene. He's not going to give these guys one inch. Oh, look at the headbutt by the Dog. Junkyard Dog doing his thing, and Fuji and Morocco the recipients. Wow, beautiful shot off the top turnbuckle by the Dragon. And another one.
That is karate at its best. What are you going to do? Try to tag the Junkyard Dog? He's greeted with a right.
This is supposed to be a tag team match, Jim.
It is not. It does not
it's
resemble
pandemonium.
Like a mini battle royal, if anything.
Referee still hasn't been able to get anyone outside the ring where they belong.
Ricky Steamboat and the Junkyard Dog thus far absolutely exploding the likes of Mr. Fuji and Tom Morocco.
Look out!
Wow. Like to carve him up in half.
Wow. Both men now going to be rammed together. Morocco manages to stay on his feet, but for how long? Uh-oh, look at this. Oh!
That's a different touch.
Morocco in dream world.
Steamboat has got him rolling in the Boston Garden this week. Watch out. Oh! Skullcracker.
Everything and anything is happening, Gene, and as usually does here in the World Wrestling Federation, pandemonium, action and excitement.
Am I wrong? Is this a Texas Tornado bout, or do we have a regular tag team match going here?
Well, I believe this is a regular tag team match, Gene. Two men have gone outside now. The Dragon is out for his team, and Fuji. Boston Garden rocking with JYD. He certainly doesn't need any encouragement, Gene.
Not in the least. Junkyard Dog. Oh, and a right. Very close to the windpipe. On the magnificent one.
They're all one-sided so far.
As it ever, Morocco's going for a ride.
But don't sell these two devious individuals short, Gene. Nice karate shot. The Dragon is really shining this week in the World Wrestling Federation.
Well, I'll tell you what, he has impressed me so very, very much. Very intelligent, bright young man.
Got a score to settle.
Come a long way in a very short amount of time.
Oh, look at that shot. A cheap shot right in front of the referee. Steamboat in tremendous pain. Can't even turn around. Morocco trying to make it over to his corner to make a tag.
He's having trouble even doing that.
He made it. Oh, Fuji comes in, is going to start dishing out some of his martial arts now.
The Samurai Warrior, one of the best.
Kamikaze drop. Fuji doesn't have to take a back seat to anybody, Gene, when it comes to that.
The solar plexus, boy, I'll tell you, the veteran knows how to do it all.
The master of the martial arts. Looked like a thumb right to the throat. JYD wandering down the apron, yelling words of encouragement. Another quick tag made. And he is teaching Morocco all those things, Gene. JYD comes in, distracting the referee. In the meantime, in the far corner, the Dragon being choked by Mr. Fuji.
That's with a tag rope. Look at this. Come on, ref. Forget about Junkyard Dog.
Hanging him out to dry over there in the corner.
Oh,
Snapmare brings the Dragon back into center ring. Another quick tag. Oh.
Boy, there was a foot right to the throat, followed by a double chop. Watch this.
Right to the esophagus. How quick the tide can turn in the world of professional wrestling. And this is the Mecca. This is the Rolls Royce of all professional wrestling. The World Wrestling Federation. Nice block by Steamboat.
Oh, a reversal on a suplex.
Well executed. He didn't have a great deal of height on it. Oh!
But I think Steamboat there was able to somewhat see that coming, and he grabbed out of the rope, but I don't know if it did a whole lot of help.
He still felt some of that. Oh, look at that knee lift right into that lower abdomen area once again. Morocco drops him with a knife edge. Fuji has taught this man well, which makes him three times more dangerous.
He was dangerous to begin with.
Former Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion. Morocco trying to come down with a double hammer, but the Dragon beating him to the punch. Oh, missed that one.
Oh. This is all-out war. Nothing less.
Number three. Look at Fuji sneaking in under that second rope. Manages to grab the Dragon, inflicting more punishment. Referee being distracted once again by JYD, who says, I'm just in the corner here.
But in the meantime, Morocco is choking. Ricky Steamboat is going to get to the point where there's just going to be nothing left of Steamboat. He's not going to be able to even muster up a tag.
They're going to choke the life out of him. And then they're going to beat him. He doesn't get some help. Wow, that'll knock the wind out of you in a hurry. Very close to the corner here. Might be able to make a tag.
Oh, no.
Morocco kicking the outstretched hand of JYD.
And once again, Dragon in the wrong corner. Referee having one heck of a time controlling this matchup.
His shirt, I believe, is, yes, it has.
Look at this, tag made, there's a tag. Referee did not see it.
What? Oh, come on, give me a break.
Referee was pushing Morocco back, and now again. He's got something around his neck, team. No.
No, I think it's a nerve hold, Gorilla.
Yeah, is that trapezius muscle? There was no tag made on the part of Fuji and Morocco.
There was not, however, we clearly saw it. And the reason the fans are upset, they saw it too. Only one in the house that didn't see it was the referee.
A thankless job, Danny Davis, the referee, trying to maintain some semblance of order here with these four individuals.
Ricky Steamboat certainly has taken his share of punishment thus far in his one fall tag team pop from the Boston Garden.
If he doesn't make a tag shortly, this match will be terminated. Boy, trying to get over there.
Junkyard Dog is just chomping at the bit.
Well, he's got to think about two things. Being able to reach him to make the tag and having the referee see it.
That has been done once already when the referee did not see it.
Danny Davis checking the arm of the Dragon to make sure he's still conscious. He is. Look at Morocco. He wants it to give up here. He wants that submission, but no way, shape, or form.
Whoa! Hold on! Hold on!
Dragon fighting it for all he's worth, but he's backing up into the wrong corner, Gene.
That's gonna spell trouble. Steamboat comes back, I don't know how effectively. Well,
some leverage behind those blows, but not what he usually has. Look at him now! There's a tag!
This place has come on good. Junkyard Dog in the ring. Fuji, Morocco, both there. Pow!
Double noggin knocker as the Junkyard Dog does his thing.
The Dog is really hanging it out this week. Took so long for that tag, you knew he was going to explode with his tag. Headbutt rocks the magnificent one.
Steamboat taking a chunk out of Morocco. Snapmare takes the magnificent one down for the cover. One, two, no. Close.
What does Junkyard Dog say to the referee? I think he wanted even a little quicker count.
Side headlock, Dog in for the ride. Drop down by Morocco. Over the top goes the Dog. Whoa, they hit face to face.
Both men colliding. Junkyard Dog, of course, a former offensive guard of the National Football League.
He knows what it's like to get hit that way.
No helmet here.
Dog very close to his corner. Could make a tag here. Hey, he's going to make it. Yes. The Dragon off the top turnbuckle with a shot to the head. He's exploding.
Look at this flurry on the part of Ricky, the Dragon Steamboat.
Oh! Karate shot to the back of the head, but unfortunately drove him into his corner. Look out, the Dragon on the warpath. Up to the top.
This could be it.
He got it.
Incredible moment upon a Ricky Steamboat. Gets the loop, but watch out.
Look out. Double clothesline by Fuji and Morocco as the Dog was thrown outside the ring.
Fuji is throwing salt in the face of Ricky Steamboat. Steamboat can't see.
Steamboat doesn't know where he is, completely blinded by Mr. Fuji's salt.
Fuji threw that ceremonial salt into the face of Ricky Steamboat.
Dog just now climbing back inside. Boy, did he go down hard.
Did he ever. What an exciting tag team matchup here from the Boston Garden.
Woo.
The winners of the match, the Junkyard Dog and Ricky the Dragon Steamboat.
Thousands and thousands of fans on hand this week in the World Wrestling Federation. All right, back at the Boston Garden here on the New England Sports Network, Gene Okerlund along with Gorilla Monsoon. What a night of action for fans as they file out of the Boston Garden.
World Wrestling Federation once again delivering the greatest in professional wrestling, Gene.
Great matchups tonight, and of course there is more on the way to this great facility. Nothing but the finest compliments of the World Wrestling Federation.